love the ultimate way to relate in marriage or male-female relation. There are many dimensions of marriage is still unexplored. The day marriage will disappear from the face of earth, there will be tremendous awakening. When I say marriage will disappear, it cannot disappear en masse. It will disappear for an individual, and it can happen only when the male-female relation attains to its fruition. In a way, it will not exist for you, yet still it will exist because it is the paradox. You have attained the transcendence beyond. Transcendence beyond the male-female relation, transcendence beyond sex, and all that relates to it. Love is the ultimate way to relate. There are three layers basically of a male-female relation. One layer is guided by the physical, it is lust. The physical needs that have to be fulfilled in each relation. No matter what position do you have, whether you are an ascetic or you are holding a high position, the physical need, the physical aspect has to be fulfilled. With that, the desires come to an end. The lust and all that relates at the physical level comes to an end. And when that comes to an end, you are transcending in a way, yet still you are entering into a new realm. When the physical needs are no more, there is total fulfillment, then you enter the realm that is known as love. Before that, all that you call is not pure love. Instead, it may have a certain percentage of lust in it. When love is totally free from lust and all that is associated with it, then it is transcendence. In a way, you are free from male-female relation, in a way you are not. You are free from the negative or the lower aspect of it, but you have now entered into another dimension, which is love. And love is the fragrance of your being. It is the way of communion with the unknown and unknowable. Then you can know the unknown and unknowable emotions, feelings, or whatever it is. The other does not need to say anything. You will be able to discern all that because your mind is easy to understand, because all communion happens through that, becomes a reflecting media. When someone comes in front of you, it is immediately reflected what is happening in the individual mind, and you can relate it in that way. Love is the ultimate way to relate. Love is not a relationship, it is the energy. When it has transcended beyond the finite boundaries, it has reached the unknown and unknowable realm, in the realm of light. Love is not a relationship, instead a way to relate. You cannot give it a name, form, shape, or anything finite. It is an unseen but realized truth. When it grips you, you are overwhelmed. It comes from the unknown and unknowable, and then it gives you the taste of your being. And before you become aware of it, it disappears. Love relates. It is a way to relate to both sentient and insentient beings. Love is awareness. Love is life. Love is understanding. Love is your being. Love is the way to manifest your being. Certainly, it is not a relationship. A relationship means that something is finished. A friendship is a noun. A relationship is a noun. And everything is in the process of continuum. River is rivering all the time. It is continuing to flow. A certain amount of water flows between the river, in the riverbed between two shores, and every moment it goes on changing. Even before you could blink your eye, it has changed. The same thing happens with love. Relationship is noun. The full stop has come. The honeymoon is over. Now there is no joy, no enthusiasm. All that is finished. When love becomes a river, it continues to flow. It never comes to an end. Kabir Das has given a beautiful name, and the Hindi word is called prem. Prem, it comes with 2.5 letters. First letter is P or pre, P. In Hindi it is P. And then the last letter is Ma. And in between there is half R and half the vowel A. So when the sound of R and A is added to the first letter P, it becomes pre and ma. The P and M, pa and ma, represents the two, the subject and the object. And that which flows between them is never finished. It is rivering, it is continuously flowing. It never comes to an end. And that is how devotion is born. That is how faith is born. That is how trust comes in. And when love continues to flow like a river between the two, then it attains the form of trust. Trust cannot be translated as faith. Trust, according to the ancient scriptures, it represents the inner strength. In one of the incidents, Jesus was communing. There was a crowd that has gathered. A woman was a leper. She held on to the clothes of Jesus somehow, and she was healed. Jesus said, "It is not that I who healed, thy faith has healed." But Jesus was a simple person. He used the word, "Thy faith has healed." What is faith? The inner strength. The strength that comes from within, that we are all part of oneness. When in the ultimate process the lover and beloved disappear, there remains, the boundaries disappear, there remains lovingness. Love only remains between the two. The two becomes embodiment of love. Then trust is born, the inner strength. Yet still you can carry it, carry relationship like a dead corpse. Life moves on just to keep your promises. You can carry it on because it is comfortable, convenient and cozy. You carry it on because there is nothing else to do. You carry it on because if you disrupt it, it is going to create much trouble for you. Relationship means something complete, finished and closed. Love is never a relationship. Love opens its wings in the unknown and unknowable field. Then you become like a bird. Bird in the beginning tries to fly, flapping its wings, and it tries to soar to the infinite height. And when it reaches in the sky, it does not even flap its wings. It simply lays stretched its wings and continues to move. In that state, when love is freed from lust and the physical needs, then it becomes, it simply lays stretched its wings and float in an unknowable and unknown sky. And before it reaches the unknown realm, it disappears. This is what you need to meditate upon. If you start seeking newness, then you are moving in the realm of the world conflict, duality and misery. Love is milestone. A little meditation on its nature changes the gestalt and directs your energy towards the inner realm. There is a vast difference between flying and floating. Love is relating. It is always like a river flowing unending. It knows no full stop. Its honeymoon begins but never comes to an end. It is not that honeymoon that you go for a week or a few days. Instead, it is the beginning of a new honeymoon. It is not like a novel that starts at a certain point and comes to an end at a certain point. It is an ongoing phenomenon. Lovers end, love continues. It is a continuum. It is a verb, not a noun. And why do you reduce the beauty of relating to relationship? Why are you in such a hurry? To relate is insecure, and relationship is security. That's why we always go into security instead of remaining in an unsecure realm. Relationship has a certainty. Relating is just meeting of two strangers, maybe just an overnight stay, and in the morning we say goodbye. Who knows what is going to happen tomorrow? And you are so afraid that you want to make it a certain. You want to make it predictable. You would like tomorrow to be according to your ideas. Love begins to disappear. Naturally, you do not allow it freedom to have its own way. So we immediately reduce the verb to a noun. You are in love with a woman or a man, and immediately you start thinking of getting married. Make it legal. Because how does law come into love? The law comes into love because love is not there. It is only a fantasy and a thought. And you know the fantasy will disappear. So before it disappears, one would like to settle down. Before it disappears, do something so it becomes impossible to separate. In the world with more meditativeness around, with a little more enlightenment spread over the earth, people will love immensely, but their love will remain a relating, not a relationship. It does not mean their love will only be momentary. It will not mean that when the physical needs are finished, the desires are no more, the couple are not making love as frequently as they, then there remains a fear that love will disappear. Love is considered as synonym with love making. It is not. The love is born only when you transcend the physical needs. then it enters into a new realm. It becomes a process. The two, the lover and the beloved, become one soul and two bodies, one reflecting the other. They start mirroring one another. Then love will have a higher quality of intimacy. There is every possibility their love may go deeper than your love. Certainly there will be something more of poetry and more of God in it. And there is every possibility that love may last longer than your so-called relationship ever lasts. But it will not be guaranteed by law. The guarantee will be inner. It will be a commitment from the heart, from the being, from the deepest core of your being. It will be a silent communion. You will enjoy being with somebody you would like to enjoy it more and more. And that is where all the instruments have been tuned. And when all the instruments are tuned, only then the music begins to flow. As long as the orchestra are not tuned, the musicians will not play the music. And in case of male-female relation, male-female relating, the physical needs at different level, all different emotions, these are the instruments. They have to be tuned into one another. And when they are tuned, the real music begins to flow. If you enjoy the intimacy, you would like to explore the intimacy more and more. And through this intimacy, you will like to reach to the core of your being. And there are few flowers of love which blossom only after a long intimacy. There are seasonal flowers as well. Within 6 weeks, they are in the sun. But within the next 6 weeks, they wither away and wither away forever. There are flowers which take years to come. Love is that flower that takes long to come. It has to cross all the finite boundaries and then it will come to blossoming. Still, there are flowers which take many years to come. The longer it takes, the deeper it goes, and longer these last. But it has to be a commitment from one heart to another heart. There is one of the beautiful composition of Allama Iqbal says, yesterday I met Jibreel alayhi salam, and he said, do not listen to the mind. If you listen to the mind, that will be fake. A heart that is guided by the mind, never listen to that. The heart that is guided by its own energy, that alone is true, and you listen to that. This is one of the lines from Allama Iqbal's composition. It has to be a silent communion, eye to eye, heart to heart, and being to being. It has to be understood, not said. Words are not needed in that state. Just a look, just a glance communicates everything. It is so ugly seeing the people going to churches or the court to get married. It is so ugly, so inhuman. It simply shows that they cannot trust themselves. Instead, they trust the policeman more than they trust their own inner voice. But this is how it goes on. It shows they cannot trust their love. Instead, they trust the law. Therefore, forget relationship and learn how to relate. In a relationship, you start taking each other for granted, and that is what destroys the love affairs. The woman thinks she knows the man, and the man thinks he knows the woman. In reality, nobody knows either. It is impossible to know the other. The other always remains a mystery, and to take the other for granted is insulting and disrespecting too. To think that you know your wife is very ungrateful. How can you know the woman? How can you know the man? Because they are not fixed. They are not the fixed assets, the furniture in the house that can be known. Each man and a woman is a process. They are not things. The woman that you knew yesterday is not there today. So much water has flown down the river. Today the consciousness and understanding is different. She is somebody else, totally different. Start relating again. As I said, that each person, male or female, is a process, is a river. River is not a fixed. Yes, the two shores are fixed and the river bed is fixed. But neither the two shores nor the river bed is river. They facilitate the flow of the water on the river bed between the two shores. Heraclitus says you can never enter the same river twice. You can never meet the same person again. And this becomes very difficult for the mind to conceive. How can? The process of change is so delicate, so subtle that you cannot see that change, that the person is not the same. The moment someone tells me that I met you yesterday, I said you did not meet me yesterday. Instead, you met my twin brother. But whenever the moment it is said to a person who has his own understanding, they do not understand the deeper aspects. They start interpreting in their own way that either it is a split personality, as the sociology calls it. But the thing is, every moment, everything is changing in you. At medical level, your every cell keeps on changing. The cells that are there at this moment will not be there when I meet you the next time. Then you have to start introducing yourself again and again. And when you start introducing again and again, it is a new beginning. You are now knowing. You are not taking the other for granted. Instead, you are relating it again and again. The very purpose of fasting is to get over the mind. Mind always thinks in a fixed way. If you are being served the same dishes over and over again, the mind says, in the morning I ate this vegetable, again for lunch the same food, and for dinner the same food. Fasting means to break away from this chain of thoughts. Instead, move in a subtle way. That lunchtime I was a different person, my consciousness and all that descends into the physical level is different than now. Much water has flown. So I am not the same person that ate this food at lunch, at the breakfast. I am a different person now. Every moment it is changing. Then the boredom of the mind will begin to disappear. Yes, the food may be the same, because food is a fixed commodity. Even if the food is left outside, it begins to putrefy. but I am not the same person. Something has changed in me, and it goes on changing every moment. To become aware of this change is the process of spiritual development. It is not like a cosmetic surgery. You continue to maintain your ritualistic way and enter into the spiritual dimension. It is completely going into a different direction. So fasting means you are eating the same thing again and again. I make my vegetables and whatever has to be made, and you cannot make just a small quantity. So whatever I make, that lasts me for a week. So every morning and evening for 1 week, I eat the same thing that I had cooked. There is never a boredom, because it is not the mind that is eating. The food nourishes the body, not the mind. Then where does the mind come in between? And mind comes and says, you are giving me the same thing to eat over and over again. Fasting means moving away from that. And mind is entering into the realm of the beyond, into the unknown and unknowable realm. That you are not the same that was there at the time of lunch when the same food was served. Then you have really understood the purpose of fasting. Keeping moving into a dimension which is unknown and unknowable. Then all that happens at the physical level becomes irrelevant. And the same thing begins to happen into the way of relating. Relating enters into a new dimension. You are relating to a person that it is not what it was before. The person has undergone a change. The consciousness has moved. Both man and women are processes. They are not things. The woman that you have known yesterday is not there today. So much water has flowed down the river. Today the consciousness and understanding is different. She is somebody else. He is somebody else. Totally different. Relate again. Start the process altogether again. However, never take it for granted. And the man that you have slept with last night now looks at his face again in the morning. He is no more the same person. So much has changed. So much has really changed that it is the difference between a thing and a person. The furniture in the room remains the same unchanged. But man and woman can never remain the same. Explore again. Begin again afresh. This is what is called relating. Relating means you are always starting afresh. You are continuously trying to become acquainted with one another. The more you continue to live, you take each other for granted instead trying to open various pages, various realms, enter into the inner sanctum of the person. Again and again, you are introducing yourself to each other. You are trying to see the many faces of the other. You are trying to penetrate deeper and deeper into the realm of the inner feelings, into the deep recesses of the being. Instead, you are trying to unravel a mystery which cannot be unraveled. And the beauty of this is, it is so fulfilling that again and again you are trying to unravel the mystery that cannot be unraveled. This is a spiritual dimension. God is unknown and unknowable. The more you try to know, the more you find that you cannot know Him. It is like the horizon that seems the sky and the earth are meeting or merging into one another. And it is just at the reachable distance. When you reach there, you again find the distance remains the same. The distance remains the same, it is never changed. And that distance, that thought has been captured by poets beautifully. Yet Krishna's foster mother Yashoda was angry because the boy was lying, Krishna, as a boy that he has not eaten the butter. But his face is covered, smeared with butter. So she trying to tie him up in a rope. Each time she tries to tie him up in the rope, rope gets shorter by 2 finger width. Either it is longer by 2 finger width or it is shorter by 2 finger width. These 2 finger width represents I and you. The gap between you and I, that you and I are separate from one another. Relating means in that process, two and I have become one. To begin to resonate at the same wavelength. Two musical instruments have now tuned as one orchestra and begin to flow the same tune. Sometimes you are going to say this, say something, the other says that even without your asking. And that is where the two instruments are tuned into one another. And when the two instruments are tuned into one another, the real music flows. Love is the real music that flows on between the two instruments where I and you, all the duality has disappeared and there is oneness. Again and again you are introducing yourself to each other. You are trying to see the many faces of the other. You are trying to penetrate deeper and deeper into the realm of the inner feelings, trying to reach the deeper recesses of the being. You are indeed trying to unravel a mystery which cannot be unraveled. But the effort is always fulfilling. That is the joy of love. This is the exploration of consciousness. And if you relate and never reduce it to a relationship, then the other will become a mirror to you. Other will become your voice. Other will become your heartbeat, your pulse. Exploring the other. Unaware you will be exploring yourself too. Getting deeper into the other. Knowing his or her feelings, thoughts, deeper stringings. You will be discovering your own stringings as well. And that is the spiritual journey. You are delving within you through the other. That is why in spirituality, so much importance is given to male and female relation, male-female way of relating. All that could not be done otherwise gets done naturally through this male-female relating. Lovers become mirrors to each other and love becomes a meditation. This is the mystical insight into life, living, marriage, love, sex, and whatever you may call, whatever name you may want to give it.